Good morning, PWAY. I'm Chris.
And I'm Danny. Welcome you to this episode, Life in Black and Gold.
This week, we'll have a school play that was put on by the advanced theater class, feature a segment on Fashion Club, give you a preview of the new podcast, We the People, created by the advanced and honors TV classes, and celebrate the successful winter athletes in a musical slideshow of action shots.
First off, let's talk theater. On March 26th, some of our talented students took to the stage and performed in front of their friends and family.
What were they doing?
Singing and dancing, of course. Take a look at their amazing performances.
Come on, honey, you waited long enough. Get to it and do it.
Okay, girls, enough.
You know what we mean. I'll be drinking up this morning.
Well, welcome to honestly, I could go on. I could have played every national phenomenon. The tide, the grass, the ground, all that was about me just messing around. I killed the deal, buried the stunt, battered the tree, now you got coconut. What's the lesson? What is the takeaway? Don't mess up now, my knees on the breakaway.
Can your friends do this?
Woo!
Can your friends do that? Can your friends pull this? I'm a little
high. Moving right along, we're truly birds of a feather. We're in this together, and we know where we're going. Movie stars with flashing cars and life with the top down.
We're storming the big town.
Yeah, speaking of storms, should it be snowing?
No, I don't think so.
Moving right along.
I can be the best.
Hey! 17, the spread eagle dances.
You can buy a copy of Broadway Cabaret on DVD from the PWAY-TV Club.
Also in theater, students in the very first ever theater production workshop class brought to Piscataway the very important play, A Bright Blue Mailbox Suicide Note.
Bright Blue Mailbox highlighted the stress and pressure that caused the suicide, made possible by the spectacular talent of the actors. See for yourself.
Called The Bright Blue Mailbox Suicide Note, written by Lindsay Price, and it revolves around our main character, Jake, who finds a suicide note in his mailbox, and he doesn't know who it is from.
So throughout the play, Jake tries to figure out who the note belongs to, and he ends up finding out more than like he anticipated, because throughout the whole thing, it's just about learning to talk to people who are dealing with it.
And throughout the play, we see how each character deals with suicide and how they cope with the idea of suicide and everything.
People handle death in funny ways, particularly suicide.
What I hoped the students learn from this is, number one, how to put on a show, because the students were not only acting in the production, but they designed the production.
We all created the show, like we built it, we made our sets and everything.
Theater-wise, I've never realized how much stage management and stage crew have to go through, because I was on the stage management team, and it's a lot of work.
It's not a stupid piece of paper!
Also, I wanted the students to take away that theater, it does have the power to educate and to move audiences. They really created a fantastic show that will be memorable for me, but I think for everybody that has seen it.
Now, our stage wasn't just reserved for plays.
That's right. We held our prom fashion show.
Many wonderful and beautiful outfits. Take a look.
On February 9th, the senior class held the prom fashion show. The fashion show was organized by Patricia Sanu and Eric Mendoza, with Mrs. Ippolito serving as the advisor. It was truly a night to remember.
Even though these past few months were filled with amazing shows, our sports weren't ones to be outshined.
That's right! Athletes took to the field and court by storm, defending PWAY, showing what it really means to be a chief.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
Welcome to the new age.
weeks ago, you may have noticed a few new faces roaming the hallways in a school. Those faces were students of the Barcelona program. And a month before, you may have noticed a few familiar faces missing. Well, students actually went out to Barcelona and experienced what all the city has to offer. And now you can too.
Esta noche bailamos. Te doy toda mi vida.
That time of year again. As some of you may know, the TV club always puts films out every year. The 10-day film challenge just passed, and in its wake, it left our club in shambles. For 10 days straight, our wonderful club put their blood, sweat, and tears into making these short films. Literally.
Figuratively.
Hi everybody, I'm Savion. Piscataway High School produced 9 films for the 10-day film challenge this year, and 3 out of those 9 films were ranked in the top 30 out of every single film submitted by New Jersey schools for the challenge. We sat down with the 3 directors to see what they had to say about the films they made.
My film is called The Lost Mission Inboxable, Episode 4. It's a bit of a mouthful, but you get the feeling of it when you watch the film. It's basically, it's about this one guy who has this recurring dream of a box in a mysterious room, and he just wants to know what's inside of it, and then he finds the box, but it's in the teacher's lounge. So him and his friend go a little crazy when they try to get in there, and there's another guy who also tries to be a part of the group, but he doesn't really fit in with them. And they try to get into the box and see what's in the box, and loads of movie references, a little bit of a genre bender, but it's a pretty good film, in my opinion.
My film was called Out of Sight. Our film placed top 30 out of 150 schools in New Jersey. Out of Sight is a supernatural film about the invisible man finding love.
Aphonia actually made it into the top 30 of New Jersey out of almost 150. Aphonia is about a girl who has a constant dream about her upcoming dance recital, which she is very nervous about. In each of her dreams, you can see a figure in the background, which represents her stage fright. Aphonia, the word, actually means stage fright, and that's why we chose that as our title.
And we'd like to give a special thank you to the teachers who let us use their classrooms and let participating students leave class early to help produce these short films.
Now, on a more topical and serious note, PWAY recently launched a new podcast called We the People, and it focuses on America's political climate and discusses their ideas and important issues that's going on. Here's a clip.
Why wasn't his, like, mental health more looked into?
He did go to therapy.
Well, yeah, no, but there were also multiple calls to the police about his mental state. He was posting on, I think, either Facebook or Instagram pictures of him holding guns. He was commenting on...
Both.
Yeah, of him holding guns. And, like, if you go on Facebook and you have, like, a bunch of friends or whatever, you're going to see some weird guy, like, all tricked out or whatever. Like... You see that guy, and you're just kind of like, because they think it's cool to have this kind of mentality of of I'm 17 and my dad has a handgun and so I'll take a picture with it. Like, it's concerning, but no one really says anything about it because you just, like, you don't want to get involved with other people's business. But yeah. He actually was disturbing people to the point that they were calling the police about him and how he was threatening people.
Read things about, like, him, his neighbors calling the cops, and, like, they went deep in, I'm not sure the name, but she said that she called just because if something did happen, that if he did shoot up the school, that she would have a clear conscience.
Yeah, I read mm-hmm. that too.
That she thought it was going to happen.
But also with that, you got to make sure that, like, she's not just doing, like, she's not just telling reporters this for attention or whatever, and, like, an actual file was claimed or whatever.
Yeah.
Also, can we talk about the police and, like, the FBI in general?
Their failure to.
It's because they're looking into Russia.
Like, they really sat there and did nothing about it after there was like more than 10 calls to his house.
And apparently what we've learned, because you said this, the officer that was in charge of this against hit
Missouri, this one guy saw on Facebook that he was threatening to shoot up the school, and he notified the FBI in his state's FBI, right? However, that FBI officer did nothing to forward it to the people down in Florida.
And
when it was clear that this citizen felt like he was going to shoot up a school, and he notified the FBI like a responsible person should do, yet the FBI did nothing, and the FBI admitted to this fault.
And I believe that's a wrap, everybody.
What an exciting few months. So much has happened, so don't forget to check back in and make sure you're caught up with everything happening in PHS.
I'm Chris.
And I'm Danny. We're signing off.
Stay going, PWAY. See you next time.